Yes, we have done some analysis, and what we would say is that the development of the last few days or weeks have clearly diminished the risk for a hard Brexit, have clearly diminished the near-term uncertainty that there is around this process. So from the economic perspective, what our analysis shows is that the UK economy should have some better momentum into the end of the year, at the beginning of next year, in terms of having some rebound in investment spending. What we have seen so far is that the UK economy has underperformed all the other G7 countries. So it used to be at the top of the pack in terms of growth rates before the referendum, and then it has moved below. So we expect some, you know, pent-up demand that could basically develop in the next few months. We agree with your colleague, however, that the near-term, you know, lower uncertainty does not really translate into, you know, a permanent lower uncertainty. There is a lot that still have to go on. And so that clearly will be relevant for asset markets.
And from a European perspective, just honing in on what this deal could mean for them, what kind of upside could we see for Europe as opposed to the UK?
Again, you know, there is some work that we have done, some work that the IMF has just presented in their latest, you know, World Economic Outlook, that shows that even European growth has basically been affected by the Brexit uncertainty. The numbers are not that large. We are talking about, 10, 20 basis point in terms of, you know, percentage point of growth. But still, you know, removing the tail risk of a worse scenario is going to be positive also for the European economies. In particular, if you think about Germany, it has been negatively affected by, you know, development in the car industry. That has been due to a variety of factors, to, you know, the regulation changes in Germany, to the fact that demand is slowing in China, and there has been some removal of tax benefit in China, subsidies in China for demand for cars. But it also has reflected, you know, the integration that the auto sector has between the UK and the European continent. So some removal or some of that will also be positive for Europe.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.